The mighty Bullmastiff is an incredible guardian and protector who will keep you and your home safe. But how can you return the favour and keep your Bullmastiff safe from the many health problems that seem to plague this incredible breed? In today's video, we're going to discuss the amazing Bullmastiff's health in detail. Welcome back to the Fenrir Bullmastiff Show. If this is your first time here, my name's Charlotte and I'm a canine leader here at FenrirCanineLeaders.com. This channel is dedicated to helping you learn everything you could possibly want to know about the Bullmastiff, then how to become high-level canine leaders that can raise the perfect Bullmastiff. So if you're a lifelong lover, thinking about getting one or just started your journey with your new Bullmastiff, then this is the channel for you. So make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you never miss a future Bullmastiff video. So let's dive into today's video and we'll take a good look at the Bullmastiff's needs in terms of healthcare and nutrition. Bullmastiffs are huge, massive dogs that with deep facial wrinkles and large jowls, typically for the Mastiff type breed. Unfortunately, their size and shape make the Bullmastiff prone to a long list of health issues, some minor, but some quite major and even life-threatening. And whilst the standard life expectancy for this breed is said to range from 8 to 10 years, many owners lose their dogs at far younger age. Sadly, it's not even rare for Bullmastiffs to die of cancer at a young age of 4 or 5, even in spite of regular health checks. And whilst hip and elbow dysplasia in any dog is painful and debilitating ailments, they count among the less serious health issues for this particular Mastiff breed.
Hey guys, sorry to interrupt the video. I just wanted to quickly let you know, if you didn't know already, I have a completely free course on the principles of canine behaviour. As a canine behaviourist, I've put this together with my years of experience, skill set and knowledge to help you understand all the areas of canine behaviour that are important for you to become a high-level canine leader, and then you can fix your dog's problem behaviours at home or maybe take the first steps into working with dogs with problem behaviors. So again, if you want to check out that course, it's completely free of charge. The principles of canine behavior, there'll be a link down in the description box below, and I can't wait to see you over on that course.
Other minor problems they can suffer from include thyroid issues, skin conditions, allergies, subaortic stenosis, and torn anterior cruciate ligaments. The Bullmastiff's pronounced facial folds are, in my opinion, beautiful to look at, but unfortunately, they give rise to an entire host of eye issues, such as eyelid deformations. Examples for these are entropion, which basically means the eyelid rolls inwards, and cherry eye, an inflammation of the tear gland. Being such a large, deep-chested breed, Bullmastiffs are also quite susceptible to bloat. A torsion of the dog's stomach that quite often occurs in dogs who have been exercised with a full stomach. If not treated promptly by means of emergency surgery, bloat is absolutely lethal. More serious health concerns in the Bullmastiffs include cardiac issues. This makes it even more important to choose a breeder who performs genetic screening and health testing on their breed stock. Some of these heart issues are congenital, but the heart issues that develop over time can only be diagnosed by regular health testing. An added challenge here is the Bullmastiff's sheer size and bulk, which means that the typical tests might not always work. And an undetected heart issue can lead to your dog's quite sudden death. Unfortunately, Bullmastiffs are also quite prone to serious forms of cancer, such as mast cell cancer tumours, lymphosarcoma, osteosarcoma, and hemangiosarcoma. And whilst there are cancer treatments available for dogs in this day and age, they are extremely costly and far from guaranteed to saving your dog's life. For all those reasons, if you want to get a Bullmastiff, I highly recommend you get pet insurance for them. In this way, you will never have to make the heartbreaking decision to have your dog put down because you cannot afford their expensive treatment. Apart from selecting a breeder who health checks their dogs for dysplasia, heart and eye conditions, the best thing you can do for your Bullmastiff's puppy's health is to provide it with all the nutrients it needs to ensure healthy growth of muscles and bones. Bullmastiff puppies should be fed a diet with high protein and fat content. In fact, a raw food diet is best to protect them, preferably with products sourced from organic farming. Out of all the possible diets for your dog, raw food has the highest nutritional content. In case feeding raw is not an option for you, a high-quality grain-free kibble is the second best solution. Due to the Bullmastiff's delicate health, you should never feed them low-grade kibble from the supermarket. Otherwise, you might accidentally help any health issues they might develop and even cause your dog's premature death. Because the Lovable Mastiff's large blocky head comes from those typical deep wrinkles, this breed needs a bit more care on the general health care front than other dogs. Unless these folds are cleaned properly, the wrinkly skin can develop painful infections. As cleaning material for the folds go, canine wipes are best. You can also use baby wipes or slightly moistened cotton balls and washcloths. For drying the skin folds after, a soft and dry piece of cloth is sufficient. Bullmastiffs have sensitive ears, which you should clean at least once a week by using a dry ear powder specifically designed for dogs. And unless your dog regularly runs around in a concrete yard, chances are that its nails will need regular clipping. You can either clip them yourself whenever they get long that you hear them clicking on the floors, or you can ask your vet to clip the nails for you. And this wraps up our discussion of the Bullmastiff's health and life expectancy. As we saw, these loving, affectionate family guardians are prone to quite a few health conditions, but by providing them with healthy nutrition and proper care, you can ensure that your Bullmastiff enjoys a healthy, happy life for as long as possible. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. If so, make sure you hit that like button and get involved down on the comment section below. And don't forget that if you are new here, to make sure you subscribe. We have two dedicated Bullmastiff videos coming here every single week. So, I can't wait to talk to you again on the next episode of the Fenrir Bullmastiff Show.